Welcome to the Wellness Enclave with Dr. Sewell. The Wellness Enclave will explore emotional health and its impact on everyday life. In the Enclave, we will address how emotional health is connected to other parts of your life, such as physical health, relationships, spirituality, and even decision making. Our goal in the Wellness Enclave is to help you become a healthier, happier you through motivation, education, and innovation. And now, the Wellness Enclave with Dr. Sewell.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Wellness Enclave, where emotional health and wellness is our top priority. Today, we will be welcoming back our guest, Dr. Mia Cowan. We will be picking up today on HRT, or hormone replacement therapy. In addition to that, Dr. Cowan is going to tell us about some more services that women have a tendency, or that women are seeking out these days. Again, we're going to have Dr. Mia Cowan on the telephone talking to us about women's health, hormone replacement therapy, other services that are very popular in this day and time, and we will be right back after these commercial messages.
Tired of the runaround and poor customer service from seasonal tax preparers? Bring your services to experienced accountants who left corporate accounting firms to serve their communities with taxes and all other accounting needs. Tax Time Accounting and Tax Services, located at 3965 Rockbridge Road in Stone Mountain, Georgia. Come in or give us a call at 404-296-2985. Tax Time Accounting and Tax Services, where experience plus knowledge equals the highest refunds.
Everyone, and welcome back to the Enclave. Today's guest is Dr. Mia Cowan. Hello, Dr. Cowan. How are you today?
I'm great. How are you?
I am doing well. I'm doing well. I'm glad you decided to join us again. I really appreciate that. unfortunately, last time we didn't get an opportunity to finish talking about hormone replacement therapy. If the listening audience remembers, last time Dr. Cowan was on, we were talking about menopause, different ways to ease symptoms of menopause, whether they be medicinal or herbal. So what I wanted to do today with Dr. Cowan is I wanted to finish talking about HRT, or hormone replacement therapy, as it relates to the symptoms of menopause. Then I would like for her to talk about whether or not it eases symptoms or it helps us ladies with anything else. HRT helps us with anything else. In addition to that, the second half of the show, I wanted Dr. Cowan to talk about some other services that she also provides in women's health, because I think it's very important, some of the services she provides. Again, she's a person who deals with holistic health just like I do. I deal with the mental health piece, and she deals with the medical piece. So, Dr. Cowan, can you please refresh our memory and continue the conversation on how HRT helps ease the symptoms of menopause?
Yes, I would love to. So HRT, or hormone replacement therapy, has gotten a bad rap in the past because there was a big study done in the early 2000s that showed that women who use synthetic hormone replacement therapy, so like your estrogen and progesterone that your doctor would call in and you would go to a regular pharmacy and pick up, those studies showed that women who were over the age of 60 and starting hormones for the very first time had a slightly increased risk of blood clot, heart disease, stroke, and breast cancer. But if you actually delve into that study and really study the study, you realize that, first of all, those women were 60 starting hormones for the very first time. They were also using synthetic hormones, and synthetic hormones are, again, your estradiol, some of your progesterones, and those hormones are made from horse urine. Therefore, they look different from the hormones our eggs produced when they were younger and still producing hormones. So what I want people to take away is that most women can safely use hormone replacement therapy to ease their symptoms, improve their health, and improve their quality of life. Okay. Now, as far as estrogen goes, some women can't use estrogen. So if you have a history of breast cancer or you have a history of blood clot, we don't recommend that you use estrogen. But what I talk about often is the most forgotten female hormone, which is testosterone. Mm. So even if you can't use estrogen to help with hot flashes and vaginal dryness and mind fog, it does help some with energy, and it has some added benefits of also protecting your bones. If started early enough and with the right estrogen, that estrogen can also protect your heart. But the women who can't use that can use testosterone, and testosterone definitely alleviates a lot of symptoms associated with menopause and prior to menopause, which we call perimenopause.
Okay. All right. So, and I noticed, I was looking at your website, and I noticed you have a lot of programs. One is called the Me Balance Program, and that's a program where HRT is used as well. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct. So as far as hormone replacement therapy or bioidentical hormone replacement therapy, which is what I focus on, so bioidentical hormone replacement therapy is made from a plant, and the hormones actually look just like the hormones our ovaries used to produce when they were younger. I prefer this set of hormones because you can actually individualize therapy. Those hormones come in a cream form as well as a pellet form. My favorite form is actually the pellet, which is what I use for the testosterone component also. And the reason I prefer the pellet is because the hormones will release similar to the way they did prior to your ovaries not functioning. So it's long-lasting. Mm-hmm. You usually get a peak at about the six-week mark, and then you level out, and those pellets actually last anywhere from 3 to 5 months. So it's exciting new therapy. It's really not new therapy. It was actually some of the first therapy that we ever used for hormone replacement therapy. But it is not FDA approved because it can't be controlled by Big Pharma because, again, it's bioidentical or plant-based. And so many of my patients use the pellet, and they notice a significant improvement in the quality of their lives.
So on your Me Balance program, can you give us an idea, first of all, of why you decided to start it? Because I'm going to make an assumption, and please, if I'm wrong, correct me. It sounds like this is something that you developed on your own. It sounds like it's evidence-based and reading on it. But it's also something you decided to develop on your own. So can you tell us what made you come up with this idea? And really, truly, what is Me Balance? Can you explain that program to the women out
there? Yeah, so Me Balance, I came up with that because I feel like when women are balanced, they can accomplish more, they feel better, they have a better quality of life, and they actually have better health. My preference for replacing the bioidentical hormones, as I said before, is the pellet. But pellets are not cheap. So I came up with my Be Balanced programs for my patients who couldn't afford to pay full price all at once for their pellets. So with the Me Balance program, I have allowed many women who normally wouldn't be able to afford pellet therapy to afford it because my first plan is just a basic program where over a 12-month period, women have the opportunity to pay for the pellets monthly included in their budget, and it makes it more affordable. So what I noticed was I had many women who were doing the creams, and I can work with the creams and make them work, but some patients really wanted the pellet and would have benefited more from the pellet. So that's why I came up with the Me Balance program. The other reason is because most women who are transitioning into menopause also need some help with their wellness and their weight loss. One of the major side effects of going into menopause is the increase in weight. A lot of women will just gain 15 pounds. They're still exercising. Mm-hmm. They're still eating right, haven't done anything differently. However, the change in the hormones can cause a significant weight increase. So many of my women were coming in. They needed the hormones, but they also needed some weight loss. And then I created the third and the VIP program for those women who really want to change their lives. They really want to do the hormone replacement therapy. They want to have some health coaching. So with those patients, they can talk to me every week. They can either come into the office or we can do an e-visit. And the focus is their total wellness, maintaining a healthy weight, and making sure that we maintain their hormone balance so that they can continue to live a normal, healthy life, including a normal, intimate life.
Okay. So, and with that, let's move on over to the intimacy. That was a good segue. So I noticed you're on top of it today. You're on top of it. I appreciate that. For those of you who don't know, this is my cousin, so I can speak to her like that.
I can read her mind.
So can you tell me about vaginal rejuvenation? I see that's something that you also offer. Number one, let me ask you this. Is this a popular procedure? Is this something that's becoming very popular, and if so, how long? Like in the last 2 years?
So mm-hmm. Vaginal rejuvenation is popular, and the way it was originally done is by surgery. So it was a pretty invasive procedure that only a few people in America could do. Okay. However, thank God for great technology, they have come up with all kinds of vaginal rejuvenation machines that are actually minimally invasive. And what got me into this is that whole intimacy portion. I noticed that women who were getting to be 50s, 60s, they just thought that their sex life ended. They thought sex was over for them because it was painful. Mm-hmm. They had minimal desire. They were having problems with incontinence. They were having problems with enjoyment. And with vaginal rejuvenation, the particular machine that I use is called the Juliet. It's an erbium laser, and what it does is it helps to rebuild the collagen in the vaginal tissue, which helps with tightening. Mm-hmm. It helps with lubrication. It decreases pain and discomfort with intercourse. It increases orgasms because it actually works around the G-spot and increases the nerve endings there. And then we also do a procedure on the external vagina, and that procedure with the laser actually helps with the cosmetic look. Many women notice that as they start to age, we have two labia. So it's the labia majora, which some people consider the bigger lips, and the labia minora, which are smaller. When you're young, you can barely see the labia minora, the smaller lips. But as you age, they start to get bigger, and your outside of your vagina starts to look different. And okay. So now women actually care about the way their vagina looks, so mm-hmm. they do the cosmetic portion as well. But it also works on around the clitoris, so it still increases the nerve endings there again, so that women can have pleasurable sex, want to have it, enjoy it, and without pain.
Okay, so let me ask you this. When do most women seek that out? Is there a certain age, or is it after they have children, or it's just depending on the person?
Yes, I think it's dependent on the person. Now, most women, say a woman my age, I'm in my 40s, I've had one baby. Some of the symptoms I didn't notice yet because I'm not in menopause. However, you know, if I'm going to do something for my patients, I try it myself to make sure it's all right. But what I noticed also is like women who've had babies and larger babies, and they have the stress, incontinence, and urgency. Mm-hmm. So coughing and sneezing, jumping, and you leak a little bit of urine, that machine actually decreases that as well. A lot of times tightness is not an issue for women who haven't had three or four babies, but you still notice a significant improvement in the enjoyment and the natural lubrication. Because women forget that even though you're not in menopause, if you're on birth control, that decreases your natural vaginal moisture and lubrication. So that machine for women who are on birth control and hormones, it can actually help with the lubrication and the enjoyment during intercourse.
All right.
So it's not just menopause that can cause the vaginal dryness and the thinning of the tissue. It's also using a Mirena IUD, using birth control pills, using a NuvaRing, using the patch, using Depo Shot. All of those things can change the vaginal tissue. And just over time and with age, even before menopause, the tissue starts to age. So my recommendation is to start working on it before it becomes a real issue. And that can be with lubricants that you use to treat the tissue during intercourse, like organic coconut oil. That can be with vaginal estrogens or vaginal steroids, and then it also can be with the vaginal rejuvenation machine, which people like because they don't have to deal with the lubricants and the other medications that you put in vaginally.
Okay, so what we're going to do, we're going to go to a commercial break. When we come back, we will continue with Dr. Mia Cowan. We will continue our conversation on women's health. We'll have the second part because I have a couple of questions about the vaginal rejuvenation. And then if we have time, I wanted you to get a little bit into the other portion of your business and of your practice, gynecology, so we can talk about when should a person have wellness visits and maintenance visits and those types of things. So, again, you're listening to Dr. Mia Cowan and the Wellness Enclave, and we will be right back after this commercial break.
Hi there, healthy people. Do you have a healthy product or service? If you are a certified medical professional, fitness trainer, author, or chef, Old Fashioned Health would love to promote your services or product on the Old Fashioned Health Radio Show. Please reach out to us. Call 404-793-3960 or email us at oldfashionedhealth@gmail.com. You can also contact us at oldfashionedhealth.com. Old Fashioned Health, good health inside and out.
I hope you dance.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to The Enclave with our guest, Dr. Mia Cowan. She's talking to us about women's health and wellness. So prior to break, we were talking about vaginal rejuvenation. So I had one or two questions for you, Dr. Cowan, if that is okay, ma'am.
Yes, please.
Okay. The first one is, are there any side effects to this particular procedure?
Well, I think the blessing in it is that there really aren't. If it's, I mean, the machine has a lot of safety features on it, so it's very difficult to mess it up. But the erbium laser, the one that I use, should only really be performed by a physician. Mm-hmm. And so that's the other safety precaution on it.
Okay. How long does the procedure normally take?
About 15 to 20 minutes. So women usually come in, empty their bladder, and then I put a numbing cream on the outside so that they don't feel the outside portion. And then that sits on for about 15, 20 to 30 minutes, depending on how they respond to anesthesia. And then the internal portion of the exam takes about 10 to 12 minutes, mm-hmm. and the outside portion takes 2 to 3 minutes. So overall, the patient would be there for approximately an hour or so, but actually being treated for about 20 minutes.
Okay, and before, and how long does it take on the average before a person starts to see or feel the benefits of vaginal rejuvenation?
It's pretty immediate. So women cannot have intercourse for 72 hours after having the procedure, and most women notice an immediate improvement, especially depending on the severity of their symptoms. So postmenopausal women who were having significant pain and dryness are going to definitely notice a huge improvement right away. Some of my other women who are doing it more for cosmetic reasons, mm-hmm. it may take two treatments for them to actually notice a big difference in the outside of the vagina. And then women with mild symptoms still notice some improvement right away, but usually after the second treatment is when women with mild symptoms would notice a significant improvement. So most women need 2 to 3 treatments. On average, it's 2 treatments, and those treatments are done 4 weeks apart, okay. and each one of them takes about 20 minutes. And then after 12 months to 18 months, you have a maintenance treatment once a year.
Okay. So when you say maintenance, tell me what that entails.
Pretty much the same thing, but you just need one. So it's still the internal as well as the external treatment, which takes about 20 minutes. But they don't need to do the 2 or 3 again 4 weeks apart. They just do it once a year at that point.
Okay. And here's the big question. Do most insurances cover it or no?
Of course not. Well, insurance covers nothing to help with women's sexual function. However, it covers quite a bit for men. So many of the treatments women come out of pocket with. But, of course, at Mibella, we have all kinds of specials as well as payment plans.
And so let me ask you this, and I know the question to this is no, but I realized when I was doing private practice, a lot of women have difficulty, particularly older women, more so than younger women, talking about anything dealing with sexual function or dysfunction. Should a woman feel self-conscious about even seeking this procedure?
No, and you know, if they have a good gynecologist, those are questions that should be asked anyway, because healthy sex and healthy orgasms make a healthy woman, and they improve quality of health, they improve mood. So when you're going to see your doctor once a year, mm-hmm. for your annual exam, those are discussions that should be had at your exam. Those questions should be asked either where you can circle the answer and then your doctor, you know, talks about it with you, or where they ask you the question so and you verbalize it. But you should feel comfortable talking about your sexual function to your gynecologist.
Okay, and that brings me to, and we have about 4.5 minutes left, so that brings me to the primary part of your practice, gynecology. So the first thing I wanted you to talk about is, what's your scope of practice as a gynecologist?
So as a gynecologist, I take care of women, usually about around the age, girls starting at the age of 12, and it goes throughout life. So women with who are coming in just for their annuals, women who are having abnormal bleeding and they may need a hysterectomy, I still do surgery and perform those. Mm-hmm. I don't perform as much major surgery as a lot of physicians because we have so many great minimally invasive treatment options as well as non-surgical treatment options for many of the problems that women complain about. So, so pretty much everything gynecology, I just don't deliver babies. If somebody is actually trying to get pregnant or having problems with infertility, I even start that workup and start it. And then if it's something that's out of my league, I refer to an infertility specialist. I don't manage cancer. I do screen for cancer, and I do diagnose cancer, but when it's cancer, they go on to see a GYN oncologist. But anything that's just benign gynecology, birth control, you know, abnormal bleeding, hormones, all of those things I manage.
Okay. So, and you said from 12 on up, so... What is the maintenance or the preventative care? Because at one point they were telling us, when I say us, meaning women, it was okay, you go once a year, you know, of course, unless it's an abnormal pap. Then it turned into every 2 years if you haven't had an abnormal pap. So what is the maintenance, and does the maintenance change at different ages?
Okay. So what we recommend is that girls starting at the age of 13 to 15 see a gynecologist, although they usually don't need an exam with a speculum or a pap smear. Pap smears don't start until 21. And I'm glad you asked that question, because that's the big confusion. Doctors are telling patients that they don't need to have a pap smear but every 3 to 5 years, which may be okay, but a pap smear is only a small portion of the annual exam.
Okay.
So I tell my patients that you need to see your gynecologist every year. If you're over the age of 65, you're not having any problems, you don't have any significant history of cancer or abnormal pap smears, then you can go to every 2 years. But if you're under the age of 65, whether you have a uterus or not, you should be going for your normal annual screening exam. So that includes a breast exam, that includes sometimes a pap smear, but it still includes an exam with the speculum where somebody is observing your tissue, and it still includes the bimanual exam where your ovaries are felt, your uterus is felt, to make sure that everything is okay. So the pap smear is only a small portion. That's to prevent cervical cancer. That's where we send the cells off. But you still need your full GYN exam once a year if you're over the age of 65.
Okay, and go over again what a full GYN examination is. And the reason I'm asking that is because sometimes people get poor care, and that especially happens a lot of times with low income individuals, and the doctors just trying to move them in and out because they're not getting money off of
right.
So can you go over that again so that the listening audience is they're aware of whether or not they're getting the right treatment or not?
So my patients for an annual exam get completely undressed, and then we do a breast exam. I feel their belly. I listen to heart and lungs. I check on their thyroid. I then do a vaginal exam where I place a speculum. Sometimes I send cells off if they need to be screened for sexually transmitted infections versus pap smears. And then I also always feel, because I want to feel the cervix and make sure there's no pain there. I also want to feel on the inside and make sure the ovaries are normal, make sure the uterus is normal. And then I want to set my patients up, if they're over the age of 40, to have a mammogram. And many women don't get primary care doctors, which I encourage my patients to do. So if I know my patient doesn't have a primary care doctor, I will do their screening blood work. And I encourage them to get a primary care doctor, especially if they get diagnosed with, like, hypertension. So a lot of times gynecologists are the first line, and it's up to us to make sure women are getting the proper care and treatment, because they tend to see the gynecologist and may not see a primary care doctor.
Okay.
But you need both.
Okay. So again, Dr. Cowan said you need both. You need a PCP, a primary care, and you need a gynecologist. Thank you for joining us this morning. Since we only have less than a minute left, are there any final words that you would like to say to the audience?
I say find a good doctor that you can trust, that you feel comfortable talking to, and make sure you ask your doctor the proper questions so that you know you're getting the appropriate care. And if you don't feel comfortable doing that with the doctor you have, you may need to seek out a new one.
All right. Thank you. Those were the words of Dr. Mia Cowan. And again, I would like to thank you for joining us in the Wellness Enclave today. I hope the listening audience has a happy and healthy week. Have a great day.
This has been the Wellness Enclave with Dr. Sewell. Join us each Wednesday morning at 7 a.m. on WWWE The Real 1100 AM. We look forward to growing with you.
Thank you for listening to another Old Fashioned Health Network show on The Real 1100.